This first smear is a basic but useful one. First, rig your minifig with Epic Fig Rig. Then keyframe your arm movement animation. You can enable steps to animate on twos. Set the cursor to the hand using Shift S. Select the smear object and set it to cursor. This will make it easier to line up. Open Shader Editor. Match the color of the hand by copying the color hex code. Paste it onto the smear object. Rotate the smear object to align with the path of motion. The smear object will appear on the first frame of the desired movement location. For example, at top of the arm movement, set the smear to be a scale of 0. Move forward one frame, set the scale to 1, and then finally move it forward and set it back to 0. This smear involves a duplicate hand. Shift D to duplicate. Move the hand on the y-axis. Repeat the frame appearing and disappearing to your desired length. You can add an extra frame if you want. This next smear uses a club as an extended arm. For this example, the arm is moving backwards and extending forwards. Use the same move object to cursor technique as before. Use G to align it with the arm. You can scale it with S to make it the desired arm length. Keyframe the animation to make the club appear and arm disappear. You can match the object's color to the arm color. If there are two colors, you can duplicate the object and split it. Tab to edit and click L to delete the bottom faces. Click Delete Vertices. Repeat with the top portion. Open the shader editor and copy the arm colors onto the smear object. You can make an independent shader. Duplicate the hand with Shift and D. Click Alt and P to clear the rig parent. Also, delete any old keyframes. Align the hand to match the minifig. Animate the arm and hand and the original one. You can also add an extra frame in between to emphasize it. You can combine all of the previous three smear techniques to create something like this. This first leg smear uses the one built into Epic Fig Rig. Be sure to rig your minifig. Keyframe your animation. You can animate on twos for a more stylistic look. Start by having the legs transition to the leg smear. Do this by sliding the Epic Fig Rig smear section for each leg. You can right-click on the smear slider and set a keyframe. 0 is off, and the numbers select the length. Have the leg be 0 until you want a smear to prevent its cycling between smears. Be sure to only have the leg smears active for a few frames. Change the length of the smears as the height increases and move them. Set it back to 0 to reset to regular Lego legs. You can animate a rough landing and adjust. The next smear also uses Epic Fig Rig for compressed legs before a jump. Keyframe like before. This time, changing the smear value to 1. Move the minifig down to match the leg smear height. It's helpful to visualize what you're animating. This example, you can picture a spring compressing and releasing. Move your rig up and add the longer smears. Like before, match the height by moving the rig up again. add arm movement to the animation. Also, adding a body twist using the triangular torso part of the rig can help. This section's animation is a front flip. Keyframe the leg smears back to minifig legs. Add other animation movement elements to tie it all together. This next leg smear is for a high kick. To get started, animate the pre-kick movement. Advance every two frames, moving the legs and arms. Feel free to move the rig's leg bone forward to make a more dynamic position. Think of the leg's path like kicking a ball. Select all of the parts of the smear piece and duplicate with Shift D. Press Ctrl and J to join the pieces together. Open Shader Editor. Copy the leg's color hex code and paste it onto the smear's color. Also select slot 2 and change the small brick color. Line up the leg smear piece with the path of motion. Make sure the leg is close to the smear on frame before the leg disappears. Add similar movement to the arms to match the leg position. Also, further adjusting the torso can help with the motion. This smear is effective for showing quick motion prior to a run. Start by animating a twisting motion to start the dash. Keyframe the movement. Add a leg smear to the back leg. You can further adjust the angle of the smear. Animate the lunge forward and arms pulling back. You can move the other leg to match the step. It looks best when a camera is added and the minifig leaves frame. This first smear is a large one for swords. Rig your minifig with Epic Fig Rig. Drag the sword to the hand. Rotate the sword to match the hand position. Parent the sword to the hand. You can rotate the sword by changing the transform mode to local. You can animate on twos. Select the smear and duplicate it. Move it to the object with Shift S. Rotate it to match the sword motion path. If the end connector is too big, you can delete it with Tab and using L to select it. Parent the smear to the sword. Keyframe it appearing and disappearing. You can adjust the timing to add more or less frames. You can also animate a side swipe with the same smear. This next smear uses three smaller smears. Send the knife to the hand and align it. You can animate the motion of grabbing the knife from the back. Also, parent the knife to the hand. Keyframe the knife scale to further add to the motion. Animate a slashing motion. Select and duplicate the smear and send it to the knife. You can edit the piece with Tab and L to remove the connector if it is too big. Rotate to align. Duplicate the smear with Shift D and move it below. You can make the last one smaller with S. Join the three smears with Ctrl J. Rotate to further line up them with the knife. Animate them appearing and disappearing. Open the shader editor and match the smear color with the knife by copying the color hex code. The third smear can be used for colored swords. Send the sword to the hand and rotate to match the hand position. Parent the sword to the hand. If you want a multicolored sword, you can duplicate it and delete sections. You can separate the hilt from the blade and color it individually using the shader editor. You can also add color to any part of the blade by doing the same technique. Animate the sword movement. Duplicate the smear piece with Shift D. Send it to the sword and rotate it. Open the shader editor and set the sword's gray color to the smear. Parent the smear to the sword. Send the smaller smear to the top of the sword and align it. Open the shader editor, and this time, set the sword's red color to the smear. Parent the smaller smear to the sword. Keyframe the animation of it appearing on the first frame of the swiping motion. This smear is for lightsabers. Send the lightsaber to the hand. You can join the hilt and blade as well. Align it, parent it to the hand. Duplicate and send the smear piece to the blade. Align it and parent the smear to the blade. If you want it transparent, you can re-import the smear from MecaBricks with the correct transparent color selected. Further align it with the blade. Adjust the keyframe timing. Here's another lightsaber smear that is used for a spinning object. Animate a spinning motion. Move the first smear to the blade and align it. Repeat with the larger smear. Again with the last smaller smear. Reposition the smears from largest to smallest. Recolor them to match the blade color. Parent each smear to the blade. Animate them appearing and disappearing at certain points of the spin. All three are at the start and bottom. Then it goes to just two towards the end. Here's how you can visualize the smear path. These are some miscellaneous smears for a differently shaped object. Select the object and align it with the hand. Animate the movement. Duplicate and move the smear to the object. Align it. Parent the smear to the object. Open the shader editor and copy the object's color onto the smear. Animate the scale to have it appear and disappear. You can also use the flag piece. Repeat the previous steps. Duplicate and scale each one getting smaller. Join them with Ctrl-J. Parent the smear to the object. Animate the scale like before. Repeat the earlier steps with this curved wedge piece. Animate it to appear after the flag pieces.